Get ready to match the stars. Bert Convy. J.P. Morgan. Charles Nelson Reilly. Brett Somers. Richard Dawson. And Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rivers.
Hello there. Hello there. Hi, hi, hi. How do you do? I've got to greet these beautiful people who've been kindly consented to be with us today. You know, it's great to work with friends. I've known most of these people for a long time, like Charles Nelson and I.
Yes, but I go deeper than a friend. I mean, what's deeper than a friend?
I don't know.
An understudy. I was your understudy. What are you laughing for?
No, that's right. We worked together on a Broadway show, and he was my understudy,
yes,
and he's superb one he was. He was ready there, and
I was all ready to go without my socks.
Are you all ready to go now?
Ready, yes, sir. I'm ready.
Okay, let's begin by saying hello to our two players, Dinah Hewlett and Roger Kissel. Dinah is our current champ here with winnings of $200. She's won one game, and we started the game at our last session and finished half the round. Roger was ahead 2-0, and we're going to go to your half of the round. But first, we are going to go to this. All right, let's continue now with Roger Kissel and our current champ, Dinah Hewlett, and finish the game we started yesterday. Roger, you're ahead 2-0. And we'll complete round one and see if Dinah can tie the score here. You ready?
Yes.
Everybody plays.
Everybody plays.
Some of John's closest friends don't know that he's blank. Did you hear that, Dinah? Some of John's closest friends don't know that he's blank. You like your answer, eh?
Oh, wait a minute.
He likes.
This is very provocative.
Whatever turns you on, Charles.
All right. Charles is thinking of a very provocative
answer.
Watch
my light go on.
There it is. Your light is on. Now, your light is on. All lights are on, so we'll call on Dinah Hewlett. Some of John's closest friends don't know that he's...
Married.
That he's married. That's her answer. Let's see if she scores with that. Bert Convy.
They don't. Not only that, they don't know that he's bald.
Bald. All right, Mary is her answer. JP, what's yours?
I'm in really serious trouble here.
You are?
Yes. They don't know he's gay.
Gay.
Happy and gay.
Yes, okay. All right.
Well, I used to be bald. I'll end it there. And so... So I will make my old friend very happy because we had an affair yesterday and they didn't know he was married.
Married. Okay, so married is your answer, Dinah, and Charles came up with it and so you matched him and that's one for you. Now, Brett.
First, I want to say that John gets around.
Yes, he does.
Secondly, I want to say I didn't say married and I didn't say bald. I said gay.
Gay is her answer. All
right.
What
a provocative program.
Dinah gave us married. What do you give us, Richard?
Well, in England, we're very discreet. We never say gay. You should just say ill.
Ill.
Not well. A mama's boy.
Okay. Married. Married is her answer. Some of John's closest friends don't know that he's...
Well, John has a friend who's a little strange, and he has no hair, and even he doesn't know that John is married.
Married, another man.
Yeah.
So you tied the score. Okay. Score here is tied 2-2, and now we'll go to our final round, and there it is. All right, Sergeant, make a selection, if you please.
I'll go with B this time, Gene.
B is what he wants. Tie score. Now, in the previous round, you matched Bert and J.P., the two of you will lay out, and you'll try and match the others. Mary called the hotel clerk and said, there's a blank in my room.
Can I write just for fun?
No.
Can I write it and show it to you later?
Okay, send me a note. Mary called the hotel clerk and said, there's a blank in my room. Just want to make sure this sergeant heard me and understood. Charles is ready. Now we're all set. Okay, Sergeant. Mary called the hotel clerk and said there's a...
Mary wasn't much of a swinger, so she said there's a man in my room.
A man in my room?
A man in her room.
All right. Charles, what did you say?
Well, she was a swinger because she didn't call down the hotel clerk to 2 hours later that there was a man in her room.
This is a very provocative program.
There's also a terrible echo in here.
Brett, what do you say? Man is the answer he's looking for.
I think Mary's out of her mind and emotionally disturbed. I said burglar like any sensible person.
A burglar. Can't match that. Although it could have been a man burglar. All right, Richard Dawson, there is a...
The gentleman who was in there burgling was doing no harm, just stealing her dresses. So I put man.
Man. So there's another match. Okay, you're up to four. Now, Betty White.
The fact that it took her so long to get the call through was only the fault of a crowded switchboard. She called 3 hours later.
Man. Yeah. You did well with that one, Sergeant. You're up to five. Very good. Now, as we go to the... second half of this final round, I've got to point out to you, Dinah, it's 5-2 in his favor. You must match three celebrities to stay in the running. However, if you go all the way here, you could win the game. Ready?
Who plays?
Last time you matched Charles and Betty, now you'll be trying to match the other four. The two of you lay out, okay? John told Mary, put your blank on, company's coming. John told Mary, put your blank on. Company's coming.
Put your blank on. Company's coming.
John told Mary, put your blank on. Company's coming. Thank you. All right.
Yes, sir.
I don't know why you should have had trouble with that.
I know.
Is your light is not on. Is
oh,
there it is.
There
okay.
They're
probably not home.
No. Dinah, may we ask for your response now to this? John told Mary, put your blank on, company's coming.
He forgot, he didn't have his pants on.
John told Mary.
John told
Mary, put your blank on, company's coming.
Robe.
Robe is her answer.
Oh my.
All right, you must match three celebrities to stay in the running, and we'll begin with Bert.
Isn't that funny? That was the first thing, but I thought, no, that wouldn't be enough for company. I thought, for company, you ought to at least put your clothes on. That's what I
clothes.
Thought.
Okay. Now, of the remaining celebrities, J.P., Brett, and Richard, you must match all of them to stay in the game. J.P.
Well, I don't know what to say about this.
Robe is what she's looking for.
I know. I put pants on.
She put pants on, so Sergeant Kissel is the winner. Congratulations. Sergeant, you've won $100, and we've got to say goodbye to Dinah Hewlett here now. She leaves us with $200, together with our thanks for being on Next Game 73. Goodbye, Dinah. Okay, this is your first game, and you're going to get ready for the big super match, and that'll happen right after this. This is the very first game Sergeant Kissel has won, so I'm going to explain to you now. You're going to have a go at the big money, the super match coming up. Are you all ready for that, Sergeant?
I'm ready.
Okay, here we go. We polled a recent studio audience and got their best response to this. Upper blank. Upper blank. Now, the answer given most frequently by that studio audience is worth $500 if you can match it. The second most frequent response, $250, and the third, $100. The celebrities here are going to help you. You're going to choose three of them, get their responses. You can use one of them or give us one of your own. You all ready?
Okay.
Okay, now let's start picking celebrities.
Brett.
Brett, upper blank.
Birth.
Upper birth.
Yes, I'm sure that's it.
Yeah, all right, that's what she says. Celebrity number two, Sergeant.
Charles Nelson Reilly.
Since I got $9,000 worth, upper teeth.
Upper teeth is what he says. And another celebrity.
Okay, JP.
JP.
Upper class.
upper class.
Very lovely.
Yes, thank you.
Okay.
Thank
you. Yes, all right. So, your celebrities have given you upper berth, upper teeth, and upper class, as we say. Now, you can choose one of those or think up one of your own and give us that, but right now, we need an answer from you.
I think I'll go with upper class also.
Upper class, that's the thing that J.P. Morgan gave you. All right.
This is good.
We are looking for upper class. May we see the $100 response? Upper plate. Close, Charles.
No, not plate.
No, all right.
Not yet.
We are looking for upper class. May we see the $250 response? Upper berth, that was up there.
See,
who gave you that,
just
Brett?
Stuck with the winners.
Brett gave you that one. Here's your third and last chance, Sergeant. We're looking for upper class. The $500 response. Upper lip. Oh, I'm sorry. Upper lip. Upper lip. Keep a stiff upper lip. Well, all right. Now you've got the $100 you won in the game and the right to meet a new player. And we're going to meet a new player right now. There she is, Fern Zalen. Okay, would you like to get on the merry-go-round there, Fern Zalen? Say hello to Sergeant Kissel there. Have a seat, Sergeant, and we'll ask Fern to tell us a little about herself.
I'm a graduate student at UCLA, working on my master's in library science, but I'm taking off the summer to be a counselor at a day camp.
Oh, well, that sounds like you got everything all planned, and I hope it all works out the way you want it to work out. Fern, the rules simply are this. You and the sergeant here are going to be answering questions, trying to match our six celebrities. You'll have two chances. The one who's matched the most celebrities at the end of the second round wins, gets $100, and the right to go to the super match where you can win over $5,000. Ready?
Okay.
Okay, let's go to round one. The challenger makes a selection, so would you go ahead, Fern?
A, please.
A is her pick, and this is it. Got a new game, folks. This is your first assignment. Though Sam was 80 years old, he still liked to blank. Though Sam was 80 years old, he still liked to blank.
Can we have that again? I gotta think of my second choice.
Though Sam was 80 years old,
I bet he
still
was.
Liked to blank. Okay, do your answer. You know what you want to do there. All right.
Well, I know.
Charles, you're thinking too deeply. We're not asking for the Dead Sea
Scrolls. Okay,
scratch.
Here's the light.
There it is. We got it. Now, Fern Zalen. Though Sam was 80 years old, he still liked to...
To dance.
Okay. All right.
What a nice way of saying.
May we call on you, Bert, for your response?
You may. I thought the punchline was be if she dies, she dies. There we go.
That's the word we're looking for.
I think he still likes to smoke.
Smoke. This is a
very good answer.
Yeah, that's not a bad answer. All right, JP.
He likes to burn, too, but he also likes to drink.
To drink.
Dance and drink.
Dance and drinking. You're looking for the word dance, Charles.
He also likes to fish. He adores fishing.
Fish, he put as his second choice there.
Okay.
That's right, fish. He couldn't spell it. All right, though Sam was 80 years old, he still liked to...
Well, I had an answer, but I knew that Jack Klugman would kill me if I put it on that card. So, my Sam is terribly athletic. He likes to swim.
He likes to swim. Fern is looking for the word dance.
This is not going
what about
too
you,
well.
Sir? Richard.
Sam was 80, and his wife liked to make love, and all he could do was go
laugh. Okay. How are we going to get any dancing before this round is
Sam
over?
Sam is no longer married. Martha passed. Now, you didn't hear about that, but the people downstairs at the home say, stop that dancing.
Betty White, you saved the day for Fern Zalen. You scored one match. And now let's go to his half of the round and see what we've got for the sergeant. Everyone plays, and this is it. A camel has more blank than a human being. A camel...
I don't believe it.
Not necessarily.
Not always.
Okay.
I don't know how
Did you hear that, Sergeant? A camel has more blank than a human being. Now, did you finish writing, Bert?
No, I'm working feverishly on it.
A camel
Am I the last one?
A camel?
Yes,
everyone has more.
A camel has more blank than a human being.
When you're ready, Bert, just blink your eyes once for yes and twice for no.
All right, he's ready now.
There must be an obvious.
We'll call on the sergeant now to give us his response. What do you say to this?
A camel has more humps than a human being.
Not the camels I know.
Are you going to tell me the Air Force isn't
Not the human beings I know either.
Okay.
I don't know.
This is about the first of the box.
Okay, that's his answer.
Well.
He says a camel has more humps than a human being.
He may be right.
Bert, may we see your
It all
answer?
Depends, sir. Were you stationed in Africa? All right, I said more stomach because he carries all that water. And
I see. More endurance.
I'd like you to say
yes,
that.
Yes, right. JP, what do you
I,
say?
On the other hand, said more humps.
More humps than a human
yes.
being.
Yes. Right.
One match for you.
Since they're still worth $9,000, I said a camel has more teeth.
More teeth than a human, and they bite, too.
Well, check National
Okay, Geographic. A camel has more...
Well, because he's in the Air Force and he's cute. And if you'd stuck with me with Berth, we could go out to dinner tonight. I said humps.
Humps! And there's another match. Okay. And now we'll go to you.
Yes, they may have more humps, but are they really happy? I put stomach.
All right, no match there. And let's check Betty White's answer. Humps is the answer.
It's nice to do a show with real animal lovers. I said humps.
Okay. So you've got one, two... I think we burned out a bulb here. JP, didn't you match JP up there?
Yes.
Yes, so would you turn JP's light on, her red light on, please?
I'll turn my own light on.
There.
Or whatever it is, while you're watching this, we'll get JP turned on. Here we go. Going to finish this game. The current champ is ahead, 3-1. We just finished round one. As I go to round two, I point out to you, Fern, that... All right, the button is done. That you must match two celebrities in order to stay in the game. All right, make your selection.
I'll stay with A, please.
A is what she wants. Now, you've matched one celebrity, and that's Betty White, so Betty will not participate now. Everyone else will. You'll try to match those. Nobody knows Mary's real blank. Nobody knows Mary's real blank. Got it? You got it. Have you got it? They've All Got It, by Joe. Fern, what do you say? Nobody knows Mary's real...
Name
is what she says.
Well, don't turn on her. They got this lovely girl.
You don't like that answer out there in the audience, do you? Well, now, wait a minute. She may be right and you may be wrong. Let's find out. Bert? Well, that's one for you. You've got to get one more to stay in the running here. JP?
Oh, I'm so sorry to say this about Mary, but she dyes her hair. They don't know her real
hair. Nobody knows Mary's real hair color.
Yes.
Okay, name is what she's looking for, Charles?
They don't know. Her real name is Mona, but it's...
Name. Another match there. The score is tied, and you're okay now. Brett?
I think I'm going to kill myself.
Why?
Because, you see, I wrote name, and I thought, no, age is what ladies never tell anybody.
You change your mind, and age is your answer. Name is what we're looking for, Richard Dawson.
Yeah, well, her name was 39, so I put name.
Okay, so you matched him, and now 4-3 as we finish this round. And I point out to you, Sergeant, you must match one celebrity to stay in the game. Two, however, will win it for you, and that'll be your second game. Last time you matched JP and Brett and Betty, and so now you'll try to match Bert, Charles, and Richard. Ready? Here we go.
It's going to be a tough match.
If John spent more than 5 minutes with his blank, he got a headache.
I'm so glad I'm not answering this.
If John spent more than 5 minutes with his blank, he got a headache. All right, ready, Charles? Bert? Ready here. quickly.
I'm hurrying.
Getting
I'm
close to the end here. There he is, ready now. Sergeant, if John spent more than 5 minutes with his...
mother-in-law.
With his mother-in-law. He got a headache. All right, we must match one celebrity to stay in the game. We go to you, Bert.
Gee, I make John sound like a rat. Mother-in-law would have been fine. Look what I said.
Children. Okay, no match there. Mother-in-law is what we're looking for, Charles Nelson Reilly.
I said wife, I'm sorry, but that's
all
the daughter.
Right. Now, you must match Richard Dawson to stay in the game. Richard, it's up to you. May we see it?
Well, mother-in-law. In England, mother-in-law and this word is exactly the same thing.
So you do not match it. 4 minutes a day. Congratulations. Step down, please. Okay. Well, you've got $100. We congratulate you. And we've got to say goodbye to Sergeant Kissel. It's been a pleasure having you with us, Sergeant. You're going to leave with $100. And let's say goodbye to Sergeant Kissel. Goodbye, Sergeant. Okay, let's get back to this lady. But first this. That pretty lady, Fern Zalen, has won a game. So next time, she'll be back and have a go at the big money in the supermatch. And I hope you'll join us next time. And I hope you'll join us next time. You were splendid as you always are because you are beautiful people. It's all over. Gene Rayburn saying so long for Match Game 73.
Today's consolation prizes are Eureka Whisk Handbag, complete with cleaning attachments, light personal vacuum cleaner for homes, cars, workbenches. This Eureka even grooms pets. And a supply of new no-drift good humor, rich, creamy tasting ice cream specially made to melt slow, drip less. Doesn't mess you up, that's good humor. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.